who really speaks for the Senate, because it's, and I wonder, is the Speaker now going to become that voice of the person who defends, defends and promotes the upper chamber?
The leader of the majority speaks for the Senate. during these last couple of years, where there's been the kinds of problems that we all know about, part of the problem is that the chair of internal economy would do his part, the leader of the government of the day would do her part, and the opposition leaders would do their part. And then we got to the point that things, there were outside of the Senate players involved, whether it be auditors or the police, etc. So I had a signal from both sides of the aisle asking what I consider taking on the chairmanship of the committee, which ain't either like a hole in the head, but I knew we needed this. It was necessary. We don't have to wait until the Auditor General finishes his work, which, quite frankly, I'm pleased he's doing. We've got to have the right machinery of management in place, because we've had a very small staff, small administration. Everything was in proportion, it seems to me. But maybe, you know, without oversight and mining down, we didn't really know what was going on. And it's necessary that we know exactly what's going on. And if there was ambiguity in terms of some of the rules, etc., some of it comes from as far back as 1867, you know, some of the ambiguity. But there are good men and women here.
Your time in the Senate is coming to a close.
Yes.
In just over a month, 2 months or so.
I've always opposed mandatory retirement in principle. Therefore, as my wife would not let me do a court challenge. So anyway, I'm going to submit to the Governor General. I'm going to resign from the Senate effective the 26th of November.